In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
Amen.
From the heart, I welcome you to this magnificent Cathedral of John the Baptist on this glorious occasion in the Diocese of Savannah of the Ordination to the Priesthood of Jesus Christ of three who have prepared themselves and are willing to present themselves for ordination. And so we welcome all of their families, their relatives, their friends, their formators, their classmates, all of those who have come together on this most joyous occasion. This is the feast of Saint Justin Martyr, a great early apologist in the church, but nonetheless a martyr, someone who was willing to give his life for the faith. And so we have a wonderful role model for all of us to remain committed to our faith and to speak out and proclaim and evangelize. And so as we begin to prepare ourselves to enter into the mystery of God's love for us in this Eucharist, let us take a moment and ask the Lord to grant us his mercy and forgiveness.
You raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy. Have mercy on us.
let us pray. O God, who through the folly of the cross wondrously taught St. Justin the martyr the surpassing knowledge of Jesus Christ, grant us through his intercession that having rejected deception and error, we may become steadfast in the faith. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Sirach. I thank the Lord and I praise him. I bless the name of the Lord. When I was young and innocent, I sought wisdom openly in my prayer. I prayed for her before the temple, and I will seek her until the end. And she flourished as a grape soon ripe. My heart delighted in her. My feet kept to the level path, because from earliest youth I was familiar with her. In the short time I have paid heed, I met with great instruction. Since in this way I have profited, I will give my teacher grateful praise. I became resolutely devoted to her. The good I persistently strove for. My soul was tormented in seeking her. My hand opened her gate, and I came to know her secrets. I directed my soul to her, and in plainness I attained to her. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Corinthians. The message of the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing, but to us who are being saved, it is the power of God. For it is written, I will destroy the wisdom of the wise, and the learning of the learned I will set aside. Where is the wise one? Where is the scribe? Where is the debater of this age? Has not God made the wisdom of the world foolish? For since the wisdom of God, the world did not come to know God through wisdom. It was the will of God through the foolishness of the proclamation to save those who have faith. For Jews demand signs, and Greeks look for wisdom. But we proclaim Christ crucified, a stumbling block to Jews and foolishness to Gentiles. But to those who are called, Jews and Greeks alike, Christ, the power of God and the wisdom of God. For foolishness of God is wiser than human wisdom, and the weakness of God is stronger than human strength. The word of the Lord.
Until heaven and earth have passed away,
Not the smallest letter or the smallest part of a letter will pass from the law until all things have taken place. Therefore, whoever breaks one of the least of these commandments and teaches others to do so will be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever obeys and teaches these commandments will be called the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. The Gospel of the Lord.
Let those who be ordained priests please stand. Jacob Almeter.
Present.
Avery Hanna.
Present.
Kevin O'Keefe.
Present.
Most Reverend Father, Holy Mother Church asks you to ordain these, our brothers, to the responsibility of the priesthood.
Do you know them to be worthy?
After inquiry among the Christian people, and upon the recommendation of those responsible, I testify that they have been found worthy.
Relying on the help of the Lord God and our Savior Jesus Christ, we choose these, our brothers, for the order of the priesthood.
Bishop Emeritus Kevin Boland, Monsignor William O'Neill, my brother priests and deacons, my dear friends in Christ, and Jacob, and Avery, and Kevin, peace in all good things. You will easily remember that you were ordained on June the 1st, the feast of St. Justin, Martyr. who was an early Christian apologist in Rome, who was beheaded in 165. I was ordained priest on the feast of the Kentucky Derby. This is truly a great day for the Diocese of Savannah. For in the presence of those who have nurtured and supported you over the years, your parents, your brothers and sisters, your relatives, your friends, your seminary faculty and staff, and priests from our diocese, on this great day of joy, I will ordain you priests of Jesus Christ. You are being called to be the salt of the earth and a light to the world. Salt brings out the best flavor, and light chases the darkness and illuminates the path so that others may find their way. In my years as a priest and as a bishop, especially my years in Atlanta and Savannah, I have learned that while people may be different on the surface, deep down, they are all pretty much alike. Whether we live in a trailer or an inner city housing project in South Central Georgia, or an affluent mansion on one of the islands off the coast of Georgia, people often share the same needs, the same fears, hopes, dreams, flaws, and joys. Whether someone is a CEO in a great corporation or a custodian, whether someone is a famous surgeon or a homemaker, whether someone is a senior citizen in a nursing home or a teenager in high school, we all share the same basic human condition with its wonderful possibilities and its frustrating limitations. And so, beneath the surface, our deepest joys and concerns are very much alike. Whether we are rich or poor, African American or Caucasian, young or old, English speaking or Spanish speaking, we all search for friendship, respect, and understanding. We rejoice when a new baby is born into our family. We want those whom we care about to know that someone truly loves them both in good times and in bad. When we make a mess of life, we try to make a new beginning. We want to learn from our mistakes. We want to reach out and help one another. When we are sick, we hurt, just the same as others do. When we are afraid, we seek people who understand us. My brothers, who are about to be ordained, why do I focus on all of this, on your day of ordination to the priesthood? Because it is a unique privilege of the priest to be with so many people during special moments and experiences in their lives. When a new baby is born, what happens? The family calls the priest to arrange a baptism. As a priest, you can see this as merely another baptism, perhaps one of seven or eight that you had celebrated on that weekend. Or you can see it for the very special moment it is in the life of that family. When it comes time for children to receive their first Holy Communion, we can see it as a very hectic time in the parish. Things are off schedule. Things are done differently. People are asking, what do I do? Or we can rejoice with the families who come to share this experience and this milestone in their children's faith life. On this occasion, the minister of the priest, in celebrating the Eucharist, and the words he shares in his homily can touch the hearts and rekindle faith in people who may have been away from the church for years. Or, unfortunately, it can be only a routine, a run-of-the-mill yearly experience. The same is true of weddings and confessions and illness. All of these can be truly grace-filled moments with the living God. Or they can be stale, dull, routine, listless ceremonies. The credibility of Christianity is undermined by bishops and priests who preach one thing and do another. One cannot proclaim the gospel of Jesus without the tangible witness of one's life. People come to us at pivotal moments in life. As a young pastor, I used to regard the emergency calls as interruptions. Interruptions to my schedule that I carefully planned for that day. Until I realized that those interruptions were a call to service, a call to minister, a call to bring Christ to another. That is the reason I was ordained. When a call came in to go to the hospital, I thought about how I would hope that my mother's pastor would respond if she were the reason for the emergency call. And when I think like that, it changes my whole attitude about reaching out and responding and being of service and being interrupted. Those moments of interruption, my dear brothers, you will find them to be moments of grace. My dear brothers, as a priest, you are called to be the salt of the earth and a light in the world. You can really make a profound difference in the lives of many, many people, as you will see very soon. We live in a world in which many people deeply appreciate the church and the priesthood, but there are others who have a difficulty in understanding why three talented, intelligent, energetic men like yourselves would want to spend their lives as a priest. It is not the kind of position which provokes much opportunity to become a mover and a shaker in our society. You sacrifice a wife and a family of your own in order to serve the people in the kingdom of God. Why are you taking this step today? Why? Because you have become increasingly aware of the deep hungers of the human spirit. You are aware of people who try to have it all, only to discover that possessions do not satisfy the profound yearning of the human spirit. You realize that the priest is the unique person who is privileged to be invited by so many to enter into key events of life as the church's representative, as God's representative. You realize that you will be privileged to baptize babies and catechumens, celebrate weddings and first communions, anoint the sick, comfort the dying, and lead the confused and the brokenhearted to the experience of God's compassion, mercy, and forgiveness. You will gather the community to break the bread of the Eucharist and to ponder the mysterious meaning of God's holy word. You will be the shepherds of the flock, heralds of the good news, and mediators between God and his beloved people. As you await the moment of ordination today, you may very well be pondering the mystery of it all, as the prophet Jeremiah did so many centuries ago. Why me, Lord? I am so unworthy. I am too young. There are many others who are more capable. In reply, the Lord God says to each of you, as he said to those of us who have preceded you in this marvelous and mysterious vocation, do not be afraid, for I am with you. I will give you the words to say. I will not leave you alone in the desert. A second thought that may enter your mind as you await this time of ordination may well be, what am I getting myself into? These are the challenging times of the Catholic Church. We are experiencing a shortage of priests. Many parishes face serious financial difficulties. Some parish communities are polarized by all kinds of disputes and tensions. The church has never been a community without problems and challenges. Jesus faced problems. Peter faced problems. Francis of Assisi faced problems. Teresa of Avila and Francis Cabrini faced problems. Paul said to the Corinthians, the foolishness of God is wiser than the human wisdom. My dear sons, you are being welcomed into the presbytery of Savannah. Your brothers are here to show their support and to welcome you into the fraternity of the priesthood. As bishop, I know these priests. I am proud of these priests. I feel very close to these priests. And I know you will too. My dear parents of the Ordinandi, thank you for the faith that you have shared with your sons. You have taught them well. We have built on the foundation that you provided your sons in your home. Thank you for supporting their call, for encouraging their call, and for your constant prayers during these years in the seminary. Thank you for giving the gift of your sons to do God's work in the Church of Savannah. May God bless you 100-fold. And so, my dear brothers, my prayer for you this day is that you will find great joy in the priesthood of Jesus Christ, and that you will be a messenger of joy to the people of this local church who hunger and thirst for God. And may the Lord grant you his peace. Amen.
Dear sons, before you enter the order of priesthood, you must declare before the people your intention to undertake this office. Do you resolve, with the help of the Holy Spirit, to discharge without fail the office of priesthood in the presbyteral rank as worthy fellow co-workers with the order of bishops in caring for the Lord's body? Do you resolve to exercise the ministry of the word worthily and wisely, preaching the gospel and teaching the Catholic faith? Do you resolve to celebrate faithfully and reverently, in accord with the Church's tradition, the mysteries of Christ, especially the sacrifice of the Eucharist and the sacrament of reconciliation for the glory of God and the sanctification of the Christian people? Do you resolve to implore with God's mercy upon the people entrusted to your care by observing the command to pray without ceasing? Do you resolve to be united more closely every day to Christ the High Priest, who offered himself for us to the Father as a pure sacrifice, and with him to consecrate yourselves to God for the salvation of all? Jacob, you promise respect and obedience to me and my successors?
I do.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. Avery, do you promise to me? Do you promise respect and obedience to me and my successors?
I do.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment.
Amen.
Kevin, do you promise obedience and respect to me and to my successors? May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment.
Stand.
pray that God, the all-powerful Father, will pour out abundantly the gift of heaven on these, his servants, whom he has chosen for the office of priest.
Lord, have mercy.
Hear us. We beseech you, Lord our God, and pour out on these servants of yours the blessing of the Holy Spirit and the power of priestly grace, that those whom, in the sight of your mercy, we offer to be consecrated, may be surrounded by your rich and unfailing gifts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
draw near. O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, author of human dignity, it is you who apportion all graces. Through you everything progresses. Through you all things are made to stand firm. Form a holy and priestly people. You appoint ministers of Christ your Son by the power of the Holy Spirit, arranging them in different orders. Already, in the earlier covenant, offices arose, established through mystical rites, when you set Moses and Aaron over your people to govern and sanctify them. You chose men next in rank and dignity to accompany them and assist them in their task. So too in the desert, you implanted the spirit of Moses in the hearts of 70 wise men, and with their help, he ruled your people with greater ease. So also upon the sons of Aaron, you poured an abundant share of their father's plenty, that the number of the priests prescribed by the law might be sufficient for the sacrifices of the tabernacle, which were a shadow of the good things to come. But in these last days, Holy Father, you sent your Son into the world, Jesus, who is apostle and high priest of our confession. Through the Holy Spirit, he offered himself to you as a spotless victim, and he made his apostles consecrated in the truth, sharers in his mission. You provided them also with companions to proclaim and carry out the work of salvation throughout the whole world. And now, we beseech you, Lord, in our weakness, to grant us these helpers that we need to exercise the priesthood that comes from the apostles. Grant, we pray, Almighty Father, to these your servants the dignity of the priesthood. Renew deep within them the spirit of holiness. May they henceforth possess this office, which comes from you, O God, and is next in rank to the office of bishop. And by the example of their manner of life, may they instill right conduct. May they be worthy co-workers with your order, so that by their preaching and through the grace of the Holy Spirit, the words of the gospel may bear fruit in human hearts and reach even to the ends of the earth. Together with us, may they be faithful stewards of your mysteries, so that your people may be renewed in the waters of rebirth and nourished from your altar, so that sinners may be reconciled and the sick raised up. May they be joined with us, Lord, in imploring your mercy for the people entrusted to their care and for all the world. And so may the full number of the nations, gathered together in Christ, be transformed into your one people and made perfect in your kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Jacob. The Lord Jesus Christ, whom the Father anointed with the Holy Spirit and power, guard and preserve you, that you may sanctify the Christian people and offer sacrifice to God. The Lord Jesus Christ, whom the Father anointed with the Holy Spirit and power, guard and preserve you, that you may sanctify the Christian people and offer sacrifice to God. Kevin, the Lord Jesus Christ, whom the Father anointed with the Holy Spirit and power, guard and preserve you, that you may sanctify the Christian people and offer sacrifice to God. Jacob, receive the oblation of the holy people to be offered to God. Understand what you do. Imitate what you celebrate and conform your life to the mystery of the Lord's cross. Avery, receive the oblation of the holy people to be offered to God. understand what you do, imitate what you celebrate, and conform your life to the mystery of the Lord's cross. Heaven, receive the oblation of the holy people to be offered to God. Understand what you do, imitate what you celebrate, and conform your life to the mystery of the Lord's cross. sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice and praise for our
Lord. Grant us, we pray, O Lord, that we may celebrate worthily these mysteries which St. Justin strenuously defended through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, and Eternal God. For by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you made your only begotten Son high priest of the new and eternal covenant, and by your wondrous sign were pleased to decree that this one priesthood should continue in the Church. For Christ not only adorns with a royal priesthood the people he has made his own, but with a brother's kindness he also has chosen men to become sharers in his sacred ministry through the laying on of hands. They are to renew in his name the sacrifice of human redemption, to set before your children the paschal banquet, to lead your holy people in charity, to nourish them with your word, and strengthen them with the sacraments. As they give up their lives for you, and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself, and offer you a constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim.
Especially the glory of ever Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord, Jesus Christ.
blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Christus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Sagas, John and Paul, Cosmos and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through your merits and prayers, in all things, you may be defended by your protecting help.
This, then, is the oblation of our service, that for your whole family, we offer you also for ourselves, whom you have kindly advanced to the order of the priesthood. We beg you graciously to accept it, Lord, and in your mercy to preserve in him the gifts you have given, that what they have received from your divine goodness they may fulfill by the aid of your divine grace. Be pleased, O Lord, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving him thanks, said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, and Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not waiting our marriage, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with light, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, the mighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to be seated in the supper of the Lamb. Only say the word of my soul, and shall be healed. The body and blood of Christ will be saved for eternal life. Let us pray. Refreshed by heavenly food, we humbly implore you, O Lord, that attentive to the teaching of St. Justin the Martyr, we may abide at all times in thanksgiving for the gifts we have received through Christ our Lord. Amen. Church of Savannah has truly blessed this day. Please continue to pray for these men and for vocations to the priesthood, to the diaconate, and to religious life. Thank you so much for your participation today. The choir, the Knights of Columbus, the altar servers, our seminarians who are here, and all those who have helped make today such a memorable occasion for all of us. The Lord be with you.
Bow your heads for the blessing.